At what point does your air conditioner stop keeping you cool? In this video, we'll talk about why your air conditioner is struggling to keep up. Hi, my name is Brian, and as a residential HVAC sales professional, one of the most common questions I get asked in the summer is why can't the temperature in my house get down any lower? Is my air conditioner broken? The answer is no, but you've likely reached your system's upper limit. In this video, we'll go over why that is and some strategies to help your air conditioner keep up. And if you find today's content helpful, subscribe to our channel for weekly educational content. Believe it or not, every air conditioner and heat pump has an upper limit on its performance. We won't go into all the calculus, but it's the maximum outdoor temperature your system can still correctly cool at. As a general rule, an air conditioner can keep your home 15 to 25 degrees below the temperature outside. So when the temperature gets to be 95 degrees out, your indoor temperature will never go below 70 degrees. And that's not even guaranteed. So keeping your home at 65 degrees on the hottest summer day is virtually impossible. And constantly lowering the temperature on the thermostat isn't making you feel any cooler. All it's doing is making your air conditioner run longer and produce air at 70 degrees the entire time, resulting in wasted energy and putting undue stress on your already stressed system. Let's take a second and discuss some factors that contribute to making your home hot and your air conditioner not performing at its full potential. First, the system is undersized. An undersized system will seem like it's on all the time and not make the house feel any cooler. Conversely, oversized systems won't help either because they'll likely short cycle, causing the system to turn on and off repeatedly and not adequately mix the air inside the home. Another reason is the unit wasn't installed correctly. Static pressure, poorly sized ductwork, and a system with leaking refrigerant can result in a lackluster performance, especially noticeable on those dog days of summer. The third reason has to do with a dirty air filter. A dirty air filter can restrict airflow through the HVAC system, resulting in a drop in performance and making your already struggling system work even harder. The last major factor has to do with your home's construction and the insulation in your house. Your home naturally gets hot as the sun comes through the windows and the hot outdoor air seeps through the walls. Therefore, homes with multiple windows facing the sun or with walls with poor insulation will experience higher indoor temperatures that the air conditioner will need to try to account for. Before we move on, if you're enjoying the video so far, please like this video and leave a comment once you're done. We love to hear what you have to say and answer any questions you may have. And did you know we have even more resources on our website? Click the link here to visit our Learning Center for more in-depth information. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more great content. Now that we know why our house is so hot and our air conditioner is struggling, let's look at how we can help it keep up. Let's start with the easy stuff. As we mentioned earlier, the sun is a major factor in how hot it gets inside your house. Blocking sunlight from coming in with curtains or drapes can drastically lower the indoor temperature. For best effect, close the drapes in the east-facing windows in the morning and west-facing windows in the evening. The second solution is to create zones in your home. We cover zoning in more detail in other videos, but it's done using dampers, temperature sensors, ductless mini splits, or a combination of the three to drastically reduce the burden on your air conditioner and help distribute the cooler air where you need it most. The ductless mini splits are standalone HVAC systems that condition the air in a single room or zone. They are great for giving you independent control over one room or area. One of my favorite solutions is to switch the blower inside your furnace to continuous operation. Running the fan continuously will help circulate the air inside your home and help remove excess humidity, which helps your air conditioner more evenly cool the air when it does run. Speaking of humidity, investing in a whole home dehumidifier can drastically help your struggling air conditioner help keep you cool. Excess humidity levels of 50% will make you feel clammy and warmer than it is. A home with a dehumidifier like the April Air E100 can help manage high humidity levels inside the house. Preventative maintenance on your air conditioner and furnace can help detect any issues and address them accordingly. And patching inadequate ductwork can help increase the air conditioner's performance and help with the proper circulation in the home. I hope by now you have a better understanding of why your air conditioner struggles to keep you cool when the mercury continues to rise. Hopefully you can get a reprieve from the heat with some of our tips we just covered. If you found this video helpful, give us a like and be sure to subscribe to get notifications every time we upload a new video. Thank you for watching and we look forward to making your day better.